We now look at a useful theorem known as the Gershgorin disk theorem. And what does it say? Well, if you look at a matrix, and here we're looking at a 4x4, but obviously this generalizes, and you look at the diagonal elements of this matrix, and you place them in the complex plane, then you can take the sum of the absolute values of the off-diagonal elements in each row and consider those to be a radius to a circle around these points in the complex plane. So here we have the radius row 0, which is the sum of the off-diagonal elements, well, the absolute values of the off-diagonal elements in the row indexed with 0. If you now go to the point alpha 0, 0 in the complex plane, and you draw a circle around that with radius rho 0 defined as such, and you do that for all of the diagonal elements and the corresponding radii. So here we have another disk of radius rho 1, and another disk of radius rho 2, and another disk of radius rho 3. Then what the theorem says is that all the eigenvalues of the matrix must lie in the union of these disks. Okay. And that's particularly useful when, for example, you know that these disks do not include the origin, because then you know that the matrix is non-singular. Now, proving this is actually relatively straightforward, so you can just look at the proof in the notes.